Good morning, Governor. Here are your files to check.
Mr. Barbachano, good morning.
Hasn't Santana replied yet?
Yes, his office responded. It says, the President of the Central Republic of Mexico has made a decision. All Mexican states, including Yucatan, will not have authority from now on in topics around the Mexican government, as all the decisions will be executed from the center of the country. There will no longer be governor in states. We thank your understanding.
This is the same thing they sent a month ago and 3 months ago.
And this time there's a message that threatens with a military invasion in Yucatan if we continue to oppose to these changes.
We cannot let them continue with this new oppressive politic that will only make our state poorer. Send General Sebastian Molas to order restoration to the Constitution of 1824 in Valladolid. We must do what it takes to have the autonomy and independence that Yucatan deserves.
Right away, Mr. Barbachano.
Is there anything I can do?
Yes, just in case, tell a designer to create a new flag for Yucatan. What a convenient time for you to come. Come look at this thing the designer did.
Sir, they have declared the war.
Yucatan, our state, our family, our home, has been trampled by non-Yucatecan authorities. First, the Spanish king and his viceroy in New Spain. What we did? We asked them for more rights and for autonomy. What they did? They denied our rights. They didn't grant us the autonomy we deserved. What we had to do? We took out our weapons, we fought, and we got free. Now, history is repeating itself. Santana with his new centrist government that makes Yucatan powerless and dependent on a country that only wants to steal the money that we already had by controlling and taxing everything we do without giving us anything back. What we did, we asked in a civilized manner to discuss it, to come to a decision that takes into account our opinion. What they did, they ignored it. They didn't care about our voice. They didn't care about our power. They didn't care about our people. Now, people of the town hall, I ask you, what do we have to do now? Independence. Yes. Independence. Today, we can make history. We can fight for our rights, for the greatness of Yucatan. Who's in favor of protecting our sovereignty? Who's in favor of protecting our people? Who's in favor of ending this tyranny from Santana? Who's in favor of making Yucatan a place where we control, where we want it to be, with the ideals of Morelos, Guerrero, and all the people who fought for our freedom? Who's in favor of the Republic of Yucatan?
We have a message from Mr. Quintana Roo, sir.
Distinguished gentlemen, your server, Andrés Quintana Roo, on behalf of the Mexican government,
want Yucatan to reincorporate to the Republic. We have heard and meditated about your requests, so we made a treaty that will give you the rights you asked for while being part of Mexico again and ending this war.
Yucatan will keep its laws and custom tariffs, and there will be free introduction of the Yucatan's products to any Mexican port.
Mr. Barbachano, the Mexican government is not following the treaty. Santana is sending right now a military force to the peninsula to end with the independentists.
We have to protect the city, engage all defenses on the outside of Merida. get the support and force of the Indian Mayas and train them to fight against those armies that are coming. Since Yucatan defeated Santana militarily, we have sent another treaty they now have to follow. We are and will from now on keep our autonomy with an exceptional politic only in this state. The Congress has ignored the agreements made 2 years ago. The President, José Joaquín Herrera, has said that our situation doesn't follow the basis of his new centrist government. The Asamblea Legislativa del Estado declares that this ceases the obligation from Yucatán to recognize the Mexican Supreme Government, and therefore, the state assumes against its rights. This declaration has been signed by members of the government, as well as from the Governor of State, Miguel Barbachano y Terrazo.
The last thing they expected was the Guerra de Castas war broke out. The indigenous people rebelled against the white people, and even though they didn't have any type of formal education, and even less education in war, they found a way to take advantage of the crisis that the independent state was going through and their advantage in numbers.
How do you expect to finish this war?
We have to request support from the Mexican government.
But we cannot do that. It goes against our principles.
Don't you understand, Mr. Barbachano? Our country is crumbling from within. We seriously need this help if we want to control this rebellion.
Government of the Republic of Mexico. We, as the government of Yucatan, want to inform you about our awful situation in the Guerra of Castas. I want to request you economic and military aid to solve our problem in this war.
We got sent from the Mexican government 150,000 pesos and some weapons with ammunition. Good evening, people. This is a message from the Mr. Barbachano governor. Companions, in the last year, our newly founded country has faced one of the worst, if not the worst, problem that we ever faced, the Guerra of Castas. We have fought for our freedom in the last decade. We have taken the biggest challenges to defend our country, and all the people present here have worked very hard to make proud every member of this state. But it isn't working. That's why today I have taken a very hard decision, but I'm certain that it will benefit us in the long run. We'll recuperate Mexico. If we don't want to see Yucatan destroyed, we need to do this. The Mexican government has given us the promise that they will help us militarily and economically overcome this war. This is not giving up against the centrist government in Mexico. This is something that we urgently need to do to reach stability again. Yucatan will still keep his autonomy, told me the President José Joaquín Herrera. It is time that we unite us as brothers to fight this war and not to focus on our conflictual past with Mexico, and keep moving, striving freedom and progress of Yucatan. We are all capable. Thank you.